Hiya folks, I've got some work to do in the garden because now we've got these extra bikes here. I'm just going to up the security a little bit because I took a panel down when we done the lawn. The digger cut had to come through the front of the front panel, so I've made a new one up now. So I've just used some featherboard and some old 3x2 battens which I had laying about, and I've made up a panel, but I've just got to finish it off. And I've got silly project man here as well, and look what he's just bought. Look, if you've seen his channel, you've just seen that he's just bought this little FZ 600 phaser. I've got the silver one, as you probably know. All you know is that he's got one now.
Coming for you.
It's like a bike shop. See you in a minute. So yeah, this is another FZ 600 phaser. He got it for a very good price. I'm not going to bother telling you the price. Don't bother asking. It don't really matter anyway. But it's been standing since... When's it been standing to?
2016, last MOT.
Last MOT in 2016. It's only covered 300 odd miles, isn't it?
Since 2006.
Oh, since 2006. So obviously it's been standing for a long time. It needs work done to it. It's got the cases here, which have all sort of corroded underneath the paintwork. They're all going to come off and be powder coated. The carbs are all going to have to come off and they'll obviously be cleaned out. He did try and start it on his channel. We started it yesterday and it ran absolute well. It was a bit woolly, but I don't think there's a lot of petrol in there either. So he did try and start it. It's only done 22,000 miles, this one, so that's really low mileage. Same owner for many, many years, isn't it, he said?
Yeah, and I've got plenty of spare parts over there under that cover.
Unbelievable. So there we go. So we've got two phasers here now. We've got two bandits in the middle. One's a 600, one's a 1200. Coming in here, as you well know, I picked this up recently, and I've also picked the RD200 up, and we've also got an RD125 twin coming as well. I did put a picture on my Retro Restore community page. Same as that, but it's got like the Mars bar colour tank. It's a black one. I'm not too sure if I'm going to keep it that colour yet, although they're quite rare, them Mars bar ones, so I might do that. The TZR, as you know, is Gary's, and that's going to be stripped down, obviously, by the end of next week, I would imagine. Then we're going to have to start work on that. So, yeah, there we go. Loads of these little projects. These are investment bikes, as you well know. And the other scooters are here as well, the Mobilette there, and also the Honda PC50 over the back there. But this fence panel, when the digger come along here, we had to get it through that front fence over there, and we have to put it back temporary sort of thing. But this was where the old pond was, as you well know, and we reseeded this on my Butler's Empire channel, if you see the videos for that, and took the whole pond away, and then it's now seeded. So I've actually made up this panel over here using these spare battens, and this is a 6 foot wide panel by 5 foot high. I'd say you buy these in 6 foot lengths, these feather boards, and for the 5 foot height, I've managed to do it with 16 panels, 16 of these basically. So there's 16 of them that's gone onto this fence panel, and I've just made it out of some old, again, not really, this is overkill. You don't really need to use 3x2. It's not quite 3x2 anyway, it's the metric equivalent of 3x2. But we had some of this laying about, so I just made it of that. So, just going to turn it around. Gary, give us a hand to turn this around. I just want to put a strengthening post down the middle. It's solid enough, but let's just spin it around. Watch your nut. So actually, this is strong enough to be as a sort of side of a shed, really. This is all I made the... your garden shed out of, wasn't it? Well, your project shed now.
Yeah.
So same sort of thing, but we only use 2x2 there, but we've used 3x2 on this, look. So nice simple construction. And if you were using this as a side of a shed, what you could do, as I said, is put maybe a membrane, plastic membrane down there, or even just some of that insulation you can get in between that, and then just board over the surface. But I'm just gonna get one more piece now, and just run it up the center there, and then screw the feather board down the middle, and then we'll go and fit that. So that's what I'm gonna do now. Put you on a bit of time lapse for that. I'll see you in a minute.
Thank you.
Right, okay, Gary's gone around the other side. What do you need here?
Take this little panel out.
Right, get it out of the way then. See, we only temporarily fitted this, so just get that out of the way.
Yeah.
Is that it? Right, let's get this one out of the way. Happy firewood. These homemade panels, so thin and flimsy. These pre-made panels, I mean. So I'll put that there. So, this is our gap. Now, I don't know or not whether or not we're gonna have to pull this little piece off of there. Can that come off of there, that bit there, look. Get the screwdriver on that. Again, this was only temporary, wasn't it? Two little robins here, look. You see them? There's one there, look. One there. And one sitting on the branch over there, just flapping about here, look. Little robins, look. Hello. Look, hello. And one over there, look. Little matching pair, look. Just over there. No, down there, look. Getting a new screwdriver a bit. Yeah, look, you come right down to us, look. Hello. Hello. Right, just take that off there then. Well, that post is definitely strong enough, isn't it?
Yeah.
But we might have to prise this off. Get that out of there. Because we're going to have to put the old panel up to that, look. Just so I can get behind it with a crowbar, you see. The post is still solid, so we're okay there. But, as I say, the panel needs to sit inside the... Hold that top bit. All right, there you go. Can you just hook that nail out down there? Trying to hit it on the hammer. Trying to hit the nail. Unbelievable. Right, and that screw's got to come out of there, I would have thought. Right, okay. Right. You're on the outside, aren't you? I'll stay on the inside. That should hopefully fall in between those posts. Right, that's that one there. That one you can jiggle about with, can't you? I think that end's got to come in first, doesn't it? Put my that end in first. That's it. That's better. That's better. So if we fix it to this panel first, yeah? Yeah. Does that bottom edge, look this way, that bottom edge need to come in. That's it, isn't it? That's it, back there. Right, so if I just drill some holes through here,
yeah.
So you just hold that where it is there. If I get one in first, that'll hold it, won't it? So that needs to come to help tip it upwards, so I need to close this gap up here. Let me just get the screw in first, I'm going to get a start on the screw. Right back there. Right, you got it? That's it, isn't it? That's it. So maybe if we get a screw, if I get a screw through this, hold that fence panel to that. Yeah, it's onto that tree.
Yeah.
Like that. Right, just hold that in line. Into me back there, yeah? I just want to pile that hole first, stops it splitting. There we go. Right. How's that? That's all right, isn't it? Right, that's good. Hold on. Yeah, I don't need that out there no more. Jimmy wanted a bit of that, didn't he?
Really?
Yeah, he might want that.
Right.
I'm sure he said he wanted a bit of that. Right, so I'm just going to whack a few more fixings down there, down the other side, and then we'll go out the front and have a quick look at it. See you in a minute. Right, there we go. That's in and solid as a rock. Let's show you what it looks like around the other side. There you go, how's that look, all right?
All right.
All she's got to do is we're just painting that. Fixed down the side nicely there, as you can see. We're right down at the bottom, so there's no chance of the dog getting out. And it's well secure, so I'm really happy with it. All I will do is put something in the middle here, maybe another shrub or something, so that this can grow back up again. And that's it, job's a good one. End of that little job. Let's get back around this side because it's starting to rain heavily now. Yeah, as I say, this was just old wood we had laying about. It's a bit overkill really, because normally it's only like a little battens really. You can see these pre-made panels, look. Look how small the battens are, look, very small and very, very, very flimsy, look. That's really tiny, but when you look over there, how much more substantial that looks. I'm well happy with that. Oh, that's better. Right, put these tools away. Always important to put your tools away, folks. As I taught my kids from years ago, and they never really followed it. So, drills go back into the drill tidy, hanging up there. So handy to have more than one battery drill. Otherwise, you're forever changing bits over, you know. So, that goes in there. That can go back up there. There we go. Keep things tidy. Start as you mean to go on. Brand new year and all that. Oh, that goes over there. What have you got there? Hey? Yeah, it's in a bit of a state, that, isn't it? He's got the old tank there for the, what's it called, the TZR. Here, this is my workspace. He's taking over. Yeah. Let's put that, let me move that engine out of the way, look. I don't know what you think you're doing in here. You've got your own blinking shed. Yeah. Hey? Let's put that back up. Oh, you've taken that back down again. I've just put that away.
Yeah, I need the socket out of there.
See what I mean? Put that over there. So what are you going to try and do with this?
I want to take the top off and get some of the crap out and then maybe get it in soap or something.
Yeah. Possibly try it with acid. That muriatic acid or what's it called? The hydrochloric acid. That's what it's called. I've just moved that engine back there, look. Huh. Hey? He's got all his own tools. He's using all mine, look. So, how many fixings is this one?
Three, I reckon, because there's only three long screws.
Right, because a lot of these are decorative, some of these screws, weren't they? They don't actually fix to the tank?
I don't think so.
You'll know when you take it out. I was under the impression all these Allen keys fixed into the tank, but not on this. They don't, apparently.
So that must be the last long one.
There we go. Yep. Yeah, so when you lift that out...
Three fix, four.
One, two,
no, three.
Three fixings on that one. I don't know what these other holes there, but that tank is in a right old state. Although I've seen tanks as bad as that or worse than this actually come back to life. So you want to, yeah, it's in a right old state in there. I don't know if you can see that or not, folks, but it is in the right old state. But we don't know whether it's solid or not. Turn it over. It's had a little dent there. Look, someone's filled that with filler. Yeah, there's loads. You can hear it in there. But they normally go around the seams here, you see. That's been filled before, so I mean that'll all have to come off as well. You want to take that petrol cap off, or tap off.
10?
Get, eh? I'd say that's a 10 mil. Get that off. And if you do fill these up with acid, folks, hydrochloric acid, for God's sake, don't leave the tap on, because hydrochloric acid, if anyone knows anything about acid and the way it reacts to different metals, it'll eat the aluminium, so never ever do that. Oh, look at the state of that. Wow. Although the filter's on it, but you can just see what's been sitting in the bottom of that tank there, look. That's filth, isn't it? Yeah, so the seams look okay, but there is a filler in there in a couple of places. In fact, it's two places, isn't it? Has that been filled there as well? That's been it's both sides, isn't it? So you'll have to dig all that out. So you don't know how rotten this is or whether or not it's going to be saveable. So best to have a look under there first, I would imagine, before you actually try and salvage anything. Because we might get away with welding a new plate in there. We don't know. Lucky enough, it's all underneath, apart from that other patch on the side. But pretty much there. That's the other patch in there. Yeah. I mean, it's solid. It feels solid. Don't feel like it's gone through. But you never know, do you? So a job in a sandblaster. But before you do that, I've got to modify my sandblasting cabinet.
You better crack on then. Yeah?
So I've now got the bits for my sandblasting cabinet. Well, I'm going to adapt them. As you probably know, I bought the wrong size pieces. These are 1¼". Let's move that to one side, because this is my workshop, Bert. So I've got the 1-inch nipple now, and rather than me buy a whole new 1-inch coupler, I'm going to use the 1¼" one that I bought, but I bought an adapter for the other end. So this should go straight into there now, like that, and tighten in. Then I can use the 1¼ adapter, and then screw the coupler on like that. And this can now be, once I've screwed it all in together, this can now be bolted up to the underside of me trapdoor on me sandblasting cabinet. I'm going to take that off and drill that in a minute. And then I can screw this through, and then that's that, but that'll be fitted to the bottom of the sandblasting cabinet. And that meter and valve, you just let a tiny little bit of air in there and it sucks the media out up the new hose, and I should get a constant supply of media then without it sort of stopping and starting. And doing it this way, you don't need to have your sandblaster full up with media. As I started doing when I first got a sandblasting cabinet, I filled the cabinet right up to the, you know, the chamfered piece right up to the top, and that it creates so much dust in there. Using this system like this, because you're drawing media from the bottom of the sandblaster all the time, you only need a small piece of media in there, and hence you don't get as much dust build up. Let's take you around the other side. So here's the sandblasting cabinet. It's a bit dirty in there at the moment. That's the new hose that I bought for the gun. And if I show you inside, now I don't have a lot of media in mine, but at the beginning, I used to fill mine right up to look sort of that level there, and the dust that used to create. And you do need extract with a sandblasting cabinet. If you just buy these out of the online or wherever you get them from, and try and use them without extraction, you're going to have this all fog up in there in no time. So that's me gun, and that's my old solid hose that I used to just stab into the media inside. And instead of that, now there'll be that meter and valve will be coming out there, and I'll be drilling a hole through here somewhere and poking the hose through there, and you'll get meter drawn out from the bottom. So that's the little door which I've got to take off. It's just a pin through there, so I've just got to undo that. I don't dare open that trap door at the moment because all the media will come out. So I'm gonna empty that media out, get the door off, and then I'll come back to you. Right, okay then, that's the door off now, as you can see. So I've got to drill a 1¼ hole through the bottom of there so I can fix that to the door. And then the media, as you know, then comes straight out through there, and back into the cabinet via the little metering valve then. So right, let's put a little hole in the bottom of that. So I just want to find the centre of this, and I'll just go to the diagonals and just draw a little cross in the middle here. That way, and then that way. And without measuring it, that cross should be in the centre. So I've got my little centre punch there. I'll just go into the centre of the cross. That just puts a little centre punch in the middle for us. Right, okay, so I'll just put a little guide hole through there first. There we go. Right, now I've got to find me 1¼ cutter. Right, so I've got one of these Starrett cutters here. You just wind it onto a universal mandrel and push that into there, and that's it. This one is 40 mil, which is not quite what I need, but I'm hoping it's gonna be all right. Just put that under there. There we go. There we go. Happy days. And there's our hole. Let's go and fit the other bits. I don't want to screw that into that cast too tight, you see, because that could split. And then that screws on the trap door like that. I want that pointing around the other way. Like that. And that is basically it. That hooks on. Then my hose comes out the front there, and I can use a regulator valve to alter the flow. So let's come put this on. Right, so here we go. Put that up like that. Push that through there like that. And that's it, there we go. So the hose comes out of here. I suppose I could kick that round a little bit really, couldn't I? just have it at an angle. So could I do that from here? Yeah, there we go. There we go. Just have that round to the side like that. And that's it, that's the job done. So I've just got to connect on the flexible hose, come around there, poke it through, somewhere probably through there with a grommet, and that'll be the hose connected. So I'm just gonna do that now, and I'll see you in a second. Right, that's the finished installation. As you can see, that's the underside of it there. There's our metering valve, which we can adjust by that little screw there. Comes up externally, goes through the casing there via a rubber grommet. So that's it down there now. There's our little outlet for our media. And that hose that comes through goes onto the bottom of the gun there, as you can see. There. The other hose there is the air line there, so that's where the air comes in. So you've got air and media, both coming in externally. Airline goes onto there, media comes in through there. Right, so I'm just going to put some media in here now. Again, you haven't got to put too much in here now, and that keeps the dust down as well. I've got my extraction there, which is the vacuum hose, goes into the cyclone, which I have shown in another video. I don't know if you can see it down there. There's the cyclone container. And out of the top of the cyclone container, it goes into a shop vac, which is sitting over the back there. So I am going to improve upon this again by taking out the shop vac. I'm going to keep the cyclone, but I've got one of those, you know, the bouncy castle pumps, what blow up the bouncy castle, the yellow plastic motors. I'm going to be adapting one of them to suck out. So that will be absolutely clear in there then. Although it is clear when I'm doing it this way. So it's going to be my last adaptation I've done to this. And that's it. So I'm just going to finish this off now and fill this up with media, only to the level where I need it, and I'll see you in a minute. Right, there we go, all back together. I've put a fresh screen protector on the inside of there. I'll just show you how much media I've got in, then we'll have a little go at blasting something. So coming in through the door there, as you can see, I've just got it barely covering that bottom port there where it comes out. So I don't really, I think I need more media than that. So I'm going to stick with that for the moment. I'll put you on there like that. And let's just get something temporary which I can sandblast. Again, just a little experiment, this one. So I've got a little cylinder head there. Let's put the vacuum on. You may not be able to hear me now. Let's just give this a quick little sandblast. I haven't done it too accurate. I've just shown you that it's working okay. And there you go. I've left some of it unsandblasted just so that you can see this side here has not been sandblasted, as you can see there, look. And that side has been sandblasted. So, I mean, you really need sort of kit like this if you're going to be restoring stuff, because if I wanted to powder coat this now, I could do, or spray it with heat paint. I'm not sure which way I'm going to go with it yet. I don't think the powder coat lasts too long in this, so I'll probably end up spraying this with heat resistant paint. But as you can see, that's the difference there. That surface is ready for paint now, just wants to clean down with a wax and grease remover. And also this bit here still got to be done there, as you can see. So that's a sandblaster for you. And I only had that little piece of media in the bottom of the sandblaster, and that tends to keep the dust down as well. Plus, as I say, I'm going to be improving my extraction as well. I think my filters probably won't clean on my vacuum anyway. Right, that's it, I'm gonna leave it here for now. I think I've done enough today. I'm gonna go inside now. It's a little bit overcast outside and it's still very cold. I'm glad I got that fence sorted out, and yeah, look forward to some more projects coming up. So if you do like my channel, hit the subscribe button there, ring the little notification bell and set your preferences to all. That way you'll get notified every time I upload a video. Check out my other channels, Retro Restore and also Retro Hacks as well. You might find something you like on there. Anyway, thanks for that, watching the video, and I'll see you in the next one. Until then, bye for now.